bright duty. Every student matters.
Hello children, welcome to the session. In this session children, we are going to discuss about the chapter electric current and its effects. So children, first of all we are going to discuss what is an electric circuit. We are going to recall, then we are going to learn about what are the different symbols of the components that are used in an electric circuit. Okay children, so let us start with today's session. So in the introduction students, we have a question for you. Do you know the reason why is it dangerous for us to touch an electrical appliance with wet hands? Do you know the reason children? And the reason is, since our hands are wet, it means we have certain amount of water on our hands, and children, water is a good conductor of electricity. It is a good conductor. Right children? So children, we can get an electric shock if we touch the electrical appliances with our wet hands. Okay children, so let us move ahead and discuss about what are good conductors and what are insulators. Okay children, so children, the materials which allows the electric current to pass through them. So children, those materials which allows the electric current to pass through them are known as good conductors of electricity. And children, what all can be the examples of good conductors of electricity? Mostly metals are good conductors of electricity. Water is a good conductor of electricity. But children, the distilled water will not be a good conductor, because the normal water has ions in it which helps in the conduction of water, whereas distilled water is the purest form of water and it will not have those ions as well. That is why distilled water is not known to conduct electric current. Okay children, then children, we have those materials which do not allow the electric current to pass through them, and such materials are known as children poor conductors, or we also call them as insulators. So this is the basic thing that we need to know before starting any chapter which deals with the electric current or electricity. Okay children, so keep in mind what are conductors, what are insulators. Okay, so let's move ahead. Children, so see, this is a simple circuit that we have been studying throughout. Even in our previous sessions children, we discussed that we need a cell or a combination of cell, and children, then two or more cells are combined together. That is, if we have a combination of two or more cells, we call it as a battery. Okay children. So I hope that you would have understood the difference between a cell and a battery. Cell is a single cell that we use, and batteries are the combination of two or more cells. So children, this is the complete circuit that we have used. And children, what is a circuit? Let's recall. Circuit is a complete path through which the electric current can flow. Suppose it starts flowing from the positive terminal of the cell, then it will flow throughout the path and it will reach the negative terminal of the cell. Then we can call that this is a complete circuit. Okay children, so in this circuit we have two cells, then we have connected this to a key, right? And what is the position of this key? This is an on position. Why? Because the circuit is complete, right? We are going to discuss about all these in detail in this session. Right now you need to understand children that since the circuit is complete, you can see this safety pin, right? So this is a complete circuit, and also we can identify the circuit as complete because the bulb in this circuit is glowing, right? And bulb can only glow when we have a complete circuit. Okay children, and in the previous class we have discussed that how we can create a switch, and using the same activity we have created this key. We have connected this key, then bulb, using the connecting wires. Okay children, so we have our friends Paheli and Bujo. They created this simple circuit children. Then Paheli tried to copy this circuit on a sheet of paper by drawing it, and she did it very neatly. She could draw this diagram, whereas when Bujo tried to draw this, his drawing is not very well. So the diagram turned out to be really bad, something like this, the previous circuit that we tried to draw. So children, Bujo tried is there some other way in which we can make the symbols of these circuit and we can recreate the complete circuit in an easy way? So yes, children, the answer is yes. You can create the circuit using certain symbols, the introduction of which you might have studied in your previous class also. But in this session, we are going to discuss these symbols in detail. So children, what are the different components which are used in this circuit? As you can observe, the different components that we have used in this simple circuit are cell or a battery is the first component. Then we have used these connecting wires. Right children, the second component is the connecting wire. Then we used the third component, which is this bulb. Then finally we used a key. So now children, we are going to learn about all the symbols for these components. Okay, so let's move ahead. So children, let's read about this. Scientists used a shorthand way of drawing the electrical circuits. So children, as you might have studied in chemistry, that we have small symbols for different elements. For example, we write calcium as Ca, we write magnesium as Mg. So how does these symbols help us? They help us in writing it in short form, because it will be a long process, long tedious process to write it again and again. So we use these symbols to express the names of different chemicals, right? Then children, similarly in physics, we use different shorthand symbols. We use shorthand symbols to create the electrical circuits neatly and yet very clearly. Okay children? So children, scientists use symbols for the components in the circuit, okay? And in the next table, we are going to learn about the different symbols for these components. So let us study about these. So children, in an electric cell is represented by two parallel lines. As you can observe, we have two parallel lines. One is the longer line, and this longer line represents the positive terminal, whereas this shorter and thicker line represents the negative terminal of the cell or a battery. If we have to make a battery of three cells, how we are going to do it? We are going to make three such pairs of two parallel lines, right children? Then we have this symbol for a battery which comprises of three cells. Okay children, then we have the symbol for electric bulb. For this, you can learn how we can make it. You can make a filament of bulb like this, and you just have to enclose this within a circle, and this is the symbol for your bulb. Okay, then children, we have two symbols for switch. Why we have two symbols for switch? Because we need two symbols, for one for on and other for the off position. For on position, children, what we are going to do is the connecting wires are represented first. We are going to learn about the wires. So children, you can see the straight lines represent the wires, and these are the points of connection of the wires. Okay, so let us learn about the switch on and off position. In case we need to show the switch on, we will connect it like this. This is switch on of the key, and in order to make a switch off, we will represent it like this. That is, we are representing that this is not connected, right? That is, the circuit will not be connected, right children? Circuit is not complete. This is the off position and this is the on position. Children, this is very important from the exam point of view. You can get a question like this. Give the electric symbol for the any two components of electric circuit, then you can give any two of all these. Okay, so let's move ahead. Now we are going to discuss about each of these symbols in detail. So children, the first one is for electric cell, and the symbol of electric cell has two parallel lines. One is the longer line and the other is the shorter line. So children, just recall, how did we identify the positive and negative terminal of the cell? So children, the terminal where we had a metal cap like this represented the positive terminal, whereas the flat disc side represented the negative terminal, right? Now how we can represent it using symbols? We can make two lines, two parallel lines. One is the longer line, and this longer line represents the positive terminal of the cell. whereas the thicker and shorter line represents the negative terminal of the cell. So children, the longer line represents the positive terminal and the thicker but smaller line represents the negative terminal. Okay, so let's move ahead. Next is the symbol for electric bulb and the symbol in the form of coil. So we have a coil in the center of bulb which we known as filament, right? So we'll make it like this and we will just enclose this within a circle. So this represents the symbol for an electric bulb. This is an electric bulb. Okay children, so let's move ahead to the symbol of switch. We have two symbols for the switch, positions 3 and 4. This represents the on position. We have represented the complete circuit by joining the two points of connection, right? Whereas in the fourth diagram, we have not connected the two terminals of the connection points. Why? Because we have an off position, that is we have to represent a circuit which is not complete, because in this case when the circuit will not be complete, the current will not flow. And we have learnt about the electrical switches, that electric switch works on the principle that whether to supply current or not. And in this case when the circuit will be incomplete, current will not flow and we will say that the circuit is, switch is in off position. Okay children, then we have battery. The combination of two or more cells is known as a battery, everyone knows that. And in the table represents the symbol of a battery. And children, we have already discussed that if we have to make a battery of four cells, we can simply make it like this. Okay children, I really hope that you would have understood this. So children, let's now move ahead. Sometimes the cells are placed side by side, then how the diagram, how are the terminals of the cells connected? So children, how do we connect the terminals of the cell if we have to connect say four cells? So children, we always connect it like this, that we have to connect the positive terminal to the negative terminal and negative terminal to the positive terminal, and in this way we can make a battery of as many cells as we want. Okay children, so usually a thick wire or a metal strip connecting the positive terminal of one cell to the negative terminal of the next cell. Okay children, and also children, in order to help you place the cells correctly in the battery compartment, the cells already come with marking on it as plus and minus sign. Plus represents the positive terminal and minus represents the negative terminal. Okay children, so even if you don't know that the metal capping part is the positive terminal, you can still find which terminal is positive or negative because it is already written on the cells. Okay children, and now you know how to connect these cells also. Okay, so let's move ahead children. Now we are going to make a cell holder at home. Okay children, and we have a very simple procedure for this. What you all will be needing is, you will need a wooden block like this. First thing you need is a wooden block, then you will need two metal strips like these. These are metal strips. Then you will be needing a rubber band like this, and finally you will be needing two connecting wires. And children, we all know that how do we use connecting wires? We use connecting wires by removing the insulation from the edges of the wire. Okay, so how we are going to make it children? We are going to take this wooden block, we are going to place two metal strips like this, one over here and the second metal strip over here. We are going to secure it safely, right children? Then we are going to take a rubber band and you are going to connect these two terminals. Why? So that these hold their position properly and tightly. Okay, and between these two terminals we can add the cells that we need to connect, and to these strips we are going to connect the two connecting wires, and here we have our cell holder ready. Okay children, and why did we use metal strips? Because metal is a good conductor of electricity and it will help us in completing our electric circuit. Okay children, so now what we are going to do is children, we are going to make the electric diagram using the symbols. So we have this simple circuit. As we can see, we have used this safety pin in place of a key. We have used this safety pin as a key as we have done in our previous activity. Okay, children. So we have this simple circuit. How we are going to draw its circuit diagram? So children, we will take a cell first. Then from the cell we have connected a key, and you can observe that this is in on position. Why? Because the circuit is complete. So how we are going to make the key? We are going to make the key like this, and here we are going to connect our bulb, and this bulb is glowing. So this is our electric circuit, and this is known as circuit diagram. So children, what is a circuit diagram? This can also come in exams. So children, whenever we represent an electric circuit using the symbols of different components of the electric circuit is known as a circuit diagram. And question can come in this way also. There can be a picture of a circuit and you will be asked to draw the circuit diagram, and I'm sure you will be able to do it on your own, because now you have a better understanding of what all are the symbols of the electric circuit. Okay children, so let's move ahead. So we have a few points to discuss. So children, the first point is, notice that the key or switch can be placed anywhere in the circuit. So children, it is not necessary that you have to place the key just besides the cell, or whether you have to connect it with the bulb. You can connect it anywhere in the circuit. Okay children, so you can connect it anywhere in the circuit. Then children, when the switch is in on position, the circuit from the positive terminal to the negative terminal is complete. And we have already discussed it. When we have the switch in on position, the circuit is complete. And children, whenever the circuit is complete, we call it as a closed circuit. Okay children, and it is a bit confusing, and most of the students gets confused that complete circuit means an open circuit. No children, the complete circuit is always a closed circuit, because only in a closed circuit the electric current can flow and we will have a complete loop. Okay children, so you can also remember it with the names C for complete, C for closed. So whenever we have a complete circuit, we have our switch in on position and we say the circuit is closed, because the current flows throughout the circuit instantly. Okay, whereas children, when the position is off, the circuit is complete. And how do we represent it? We represent it by an open circuit, right? Because we have not connected it over these two connection points, right? We haven't connected it, right? So we have this off position, we call it as an open circuit. And in case of open circuit, the circuit will be incomplete. Okay children, so you have to remember it carefully. Whenever the switch is off, we have open circuit. Whenever with the switch is on, we have the closed circuit. Okay children, this is really really important, keep it in mind. Okay children, so let's move ahead. So children, what was the filament? You remember, we have discussed that we have a bulb, and in the center of bulb you can observe a thin wire, and this thin wire is known as filament, and it was made using a metal tungsten, right? And sometimes the bulb was fused, and how we can identify a fused bulb? That this wire will be broken, and whenever this wire will be broken, the circuit will break, and when the circuit breaks, the circuit will be incomplete and the bulb will not glow. Okay children, so this was all about the filament that you have to keep in mind. Let's move ahead. So children, we have a little caution for us that you should never touch an electric bulb connected to the mains. Why? Because it can be very hot. We are going to discuss about this heating effect of electric current in this chapter. Okay children, because when the switch is on, the bulb is on for some time, you should never touch it directly, because it can be very hot. Okay children, and you should never experiment with the electric supply from the mains or the generator or an inverter. Why? Because you can get an electric shock and it can be very dangerous children. Okay, so for any activity that we are going to do in this chapter, we are just going to use only and only the cells. Okay children, right? Understood? So that's it guys, this was all about the introduction part of this chapter and I really hope that you would have understood it really well. Thank you so much for your attention.